Hello there, kitties. I'm Kerry, the vacuum tube witch. And it's time that the previously drilled chassis for the DD-12 Dirty Dozen amp saw some action with a saw. Gotta cut the transformer hose and also the power socket hole. Hopefully there are no problems with it. Let's get to the bench. And it's gonna be a little bit of work. Got this pretty practical so that it's gonna be the first time I'm working with it. And in order to use it, first I need to remove the blade, put it through a hole. Maybe let's start with the power socket hole. There might be one problem. No, it's not a problem. It can go through 4 millimeters because there's a piece of wire. If you take a closer look, there's a piece of cross wire that might not want to go through the hole, but it's not the case with this blade and 4 millimeter holes. So gotta put it through. It may also be the case that on one side it's shorter than on the other. Anyway, I'm gonna put it through and I loosen it some more. Then I've got to clamp it and tighten the handle. Yeah, that's pretty tight, almost tighter than Ethel Granger slices. And it's time to sew that rectangular hole. Maybe doing it, letting gravity help me is a good idea here. Let's turn it a little bit to the side. Maybe not that much. I think I've gone a little bit too far. sealer still needs to use a file to make the edges smooth. Let's get a better view on this one. And again, gravity! I'm not an astronaut. Gravity can help me. Astronauts, war heroes, and Olympians. You're here because you're it. Because you're the best. We want the best, and you're it. Oh, for crying out loud. Not as easy as I thought. Not as easy. And let's try this again. We're in the next hole. And it's going! And here I will have to turn the blade backwards. And this is gonna be a little bit tricky. Because I not only have to turn it backwards, but I also have to turn the blade holders backwards. Otherwise I would have not enough space to fit them. So all I have to do is just turning the blade out of its holders while it is taken out. Use some force, Kari. Use the force. This is the way. Use the force. And with holders facing backwards and the saw teeth also facing backwards, I can do the last line. And I've got a roughly rectangular hole that I can make a lot smoother with a file. Yeah, let's grab a file and make it nice. And a piece of wood to put the working piece on. Careful not to overdo it. Now that I've got those longer edges pretty much done, I can do the shorter edges. I will still need a narrower file. Is this okay now? It's a triangular one, but it will do the job. Test with the socket. Doesn't wanna go in yet. Make it a little bit wider. fits in very nicely. So, just a little bit of a smoothing of the edges here. That's it for this one. Start with another. And this is gonna be a lot longer and a lot more complex. Seriously, it's gonna take a lot of work. Like before, start around by putting the blade for a hole and fixing the blade in the holders. Maybe I should just do it from the right side. I think it's gonna be better to do it horizontally. At the end, I will need to remove a bit of the metal. I'll do it with a screwdriver. And time to change the direction. Thank you. The end is nigh. The end for this side. Gotta be careful not to bend the saw blade. Like before, remove the bridge with a screwdriver. And here I will also have to turn the blade around. Maybe 90 degrees. And the last one. Hope it's gonna be a piece of cake. And like they say, the cake is a lie. I do it from the other side. Yeah. That's the rectangular hole for now. Not great, not terrible. Time for some firework. And the last edge. Got a nice rectangular hole here. Let's see if it matches the transformer. Could be a little bit longer. Thank you. looks really good. And it's time for the main transformer that's gonna be a lot more complex in shape. This is gonna take some fiddling. Just one side. There's a lot of work to do. And now most of the time it's me and not the machine doing the work. So I'm sweating like a pig. But I know that at the end of the day, all this sweat has not gone in vain. It will be the sign of good work done. Another bridge to remove. Some final cuts. That's the second edge, still got two of them. I'll go back where I started. it's getting closer and closer and closer and closer and closer. It's almost there. Just a centimeter or something like that. Hold on, carry on. Hold on and carry on. And time for the final moment. That's it. This is far from perfect, but it's good enough. Time for fireworks. A lot of work and patience. And I've been doing it for something like 20 years. Maybe it was not the case that I was making those amps every day, but every now and then I made an amp. End to end. And time to see where this takes us, putting a transformer through the hole. Bit narrow on this side. try now. That's a lot better. Cut this a little bit outwards. That's about perfect. Loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. So, it's time to remove all the residue and scratch the surface again to give it a nice, shiny, elegant polish. And I will do it off the camera, and the next episode will be the mechanical fitting of the components in the chassis. I will also be making a clamp for the filter cap so that I can attach it to the chassis, because I don't have any ready-made clamps. So I will have to make a new one, and I will guide you through what you're gonna do if you need to make one, how to design one. We'll do it together. Ha! Time to recombobulate the bench. And see you next time!